Soul Sessions. Soul Sessions. Yeah, yeah. Soul Sessions. We got the Soul Sessions.
Kia ora, malole saufua maua, malalangi mama, whakalofa lahi atu, and welcome to Soul Sessions, a show celebrating Aotearoa's gospel music. Today we're joined by another special artist, so special in fact she's worked with Stan Walker, Teeks and Sons of Zion. She's now making a name for herself as a solo artist in her own right. Here's Gin Papāli'i singing a rendition of Cece Winans' Alabaster Box. Ballad. Gin, welcome to the show. It's great to have you.
Oh, thank you for having me. I'm excited to be here.
How are you feeling after that ballad? Because Cece Winans, that won the Best Contemporary Gospel Song at the Dove Awards, which are the equivalent of the Grammys.
Oh.
It's a massive song,
It is a massive song, but I loved it. Full of passion and deep meaning, so it was fun.
Really, really moving. Mm. And so where did music start for you as a child growing up?
Well, I actually started singing in church like so many people, and I play violin and used to play piano, so my mum got us into music lessons.
Yes.
I started at the age of 4 on violin and piano and started singing from a young age in church. So, yeah, I think that has really helped. And then I went on to study at Excel, School of Performing Arts, and Auckland University for music. So, and vocal lessons outside of that too. So that's really helped.
And it sounds as though it's in your blood to do music. What's one of the most sort of early childhood memories you have when you first started singing on the stage?
Probably the first one I can really remember. Well, apparently, before I started talking, I started singing.
Yeah.
So,
that's a good indication.
Yeah. But But the first time on stage was probably at like a Christmas play at church mm-hmm. or something, I think. That's what I can first remember.
Yeah. And it's really good, like those Sunday school church repetition and practices and training. So your mum's had a big influence on your music?
Yes. So she was a classical opera singer.
Wow.
And she just decided she wanted her kids to develop their skills. So that's what she put the focus on, I guess, rather than buying us lots of stuff. And it's really helped us. All my siblings sing. We all play instruments.
You got a bit of a quartet thing going on with your siblings?
Yes. So, sorry, I've got 5 siblings. 4 of us sing and 4 of us have a string quartet. But my brother's in Wellington now. He's a surgeon. So we have a friend that's coming. We have a string quartet called Ebony Strings.
Wow.
So we play for different artists if they need us or different functions. So, yeah.
It's amazing. And then you transitioned and did a Masters of Music.
Yeah.
How was that, studying and then doing performance music at the same time?
Yeah, it was a challenge, I guess. So in my undergrad, I did jazz voice and a bit of conducting and classical performance violin. Then when I went on to do my master's in violin, because not many people did it in contemporary voice, I guess, at the time. But I would say voice is more my passion, but certainly the disciplines that I've learnt in violin and strings has helped me in my vocal performance. So, yeah.
Great. Well, we definitely look forward to hearing more of you, Gin.
Thank you.
Merging that classic gospel sound together. You don't want to miss out. Here we like to hanuchu, and I'm joined by Gin Papāli'i. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
Now, hanuchu actually means to chat, to talk.
Awesome.
Tumen, so we get to merge a little bit of our culture into the show.
Nice.
And you're Kiwi Samoan.
Yes.
So tell me a bit about your heritage.
Okay, so my mum was born in Samoa. We're from Sapapali'i in Savai'i. And my dad is Kiwi, European. But I grew up mainly with my mum's side. My parents are divorced, so we've got the last name's hyphenated, Papāli'i-Curtin, so shows both sides of my heritage, which is really cool. I love to, obviously I sing in English mostly, but I also do sing in Samoan from time to time, and I would love to do more of that because it's a big part of who I am and I'm proud to be Samoan, and so, yeah.
Well, that's it's cool. Great to be able to use music to infuse with our culture and our heritage.
Yeah, absolutely.
And you've got some music coming out towards the end of this year. It's your first time sort of doing some musical arrangements, is it?
Yeah, I've got a couple of songs coming out this year. But it's just good to be able to put out new music and make music videos after COVID.
And I'm really interested to see you're multi-talented because you don't just sing, you play the violin as well. How far along your journey with violin did you get? Because it can get pretty rigorous in the classic. Classical music.
Yeah, so I did my master's in classical violin and did the whole orchestras, quartets, chamber music stuff. But at the same time, I've always loved contemporary singing and vocals, so I try and keep them both going, I guess. You've got to follow what you love, follow your passion.
Yeah.
But I find both help me to, they just give me insight into the different worlds of music, so it's interesting.
Definitely. Yeah. And we look forward to hearing that sort of blend in your next song.
Thank you.
Which is, going to share a lot of your roots. So would you like to introduce it for us and tell us a bit about it?
Sure. So next up, I'm going to be performing a gospel version of How Great Thou Art. I'm going to see a bit of violin in there too. I'm going to be singing with my sister Ruby and my friend Andrew Faleatua.
Consider all
It's Hanuchu time here at Soul Sessions. I'm with Gin Papāli'i. Welcome, it's so good to have you.
Oh, thank you.
You're a talented vocalist and teacher. And so tell me a little bit more about this connection with gospel. How do you feel when you perform these amazing songs?
Honestly, I feel like I'm flying. Gospel's probably my number one passion for singing. And I think it's because I feel that connection with my faith, with God when I sing. Mm. It's probably one of the biggest ways that I feel like I can connect with him. Yeah, it's just an amazing feeling.
Eh? Yeah, And there's something about doing it live, eh?
Oh, yeah.
Changes sure. every time.
It does, yeah. It sure does.
And you look forward to recording a bit of this sort of gospel style and some music coming up in later on?
We're working on the single of How Great Thou Art, so looking forward to releasing that when it's ready, sure.
Oh, well, we look forward to it. Now, we're going to do a lot of quick-fire questions now, which we ask our artists each week. So just the first thing that comes off your mind, just say it, all right?
Okay.
So if you could collaborate with any gospel artist, who would it be and why?
The Sunday Service Choir.
Harp or horn?
My mum played the harp. For now, I'm going to go with the French horn.
What's your most memorable Sunday school song?
The first one that comes to mind is Jesus Loves Me, This I Know.
For the Bible tells me so.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
What's your favourite Pacific gospel song?
I love How Great Thou Art in Māori and Psalm 1, actually. Yes, there are so many good ones, but that's definitely, it is one of my favourites.
If you could be any biblical character, who would it be and why?
Probably would have to be one of Jesus' disciples just to see all his miracles and, meet him in real life, I would have to say.
Yeah, and doing, communion, pass it around.
Sure, haven't thought of that either. I mean, thank you for bringing this up. I overthink when I go home.
All right, let's just say we're planning a trip to the Holy Land together. Yep. Is there a particular place that you want to go?
I'd love to go to Bethlehem and see where Jesus was born, I suppose. There are so many places. We can only hope and see.
Yeah, well, who knows? Maybe we could do a soul session over there once.
You never know.
You never know. Gin, it's been great having you on the show today. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you so much for having me.
We're getting to that part where we get to do our soul session and this duet. Oh, I'm excited to hear this arrangement.
Nice.
I don't think I've heard it before. You want to introduce it for our audience?
Sure thing. Okay, so this next song is a rendition of The Lord Is My Light by Adeaze, and I'm going to be singing with Sara-Jane, my sister Ruby, and Andrew Faleatua again on the keys.
Oh, I'll take faith.
Thank you for joining us at Soul Sessions. That's us for this week, featuring Gin Papāli'i. Tō whasau fua!